do we sit when we can stand? We sit all day long when we could be out smelling the aroma of busy lives and our many people. We could walk the streets in New York City and taste the builders and painters and tourists and restaurant workers and all of those hardworking people who live in this world called New York. And hear Starbucks and McDonald's and Barnes & Noble and all the other shops and all these dirty streets that everyone loves. And feel the old gum and the trash cans and the empty coffee cups and the crumpled up paper and the squashed Cheez-Its. And see the minds of the happy, the sad, the hopeful, the newborn, the old, the overworked, and the spoiled. Though we're all dreaming of our fair city deep down inside.
I walk. I taste the slightly rotten hamburger. I wish I was sitting and relaxing instead of walking these dirty streets, trying to keep up my energy. New York. Smells like sewer rats and rotting garbage. I hate the sound of cars honking their horns while I'm trying to sleep, and the sight of old gum pressed down the street, and the many people stepping on it and shoveling me to the side. I don't even want to tell you what the sidewalk feels like when you fall. I'll say it anyway. It feels dirty and crap. I feel that old gum. I know everyone here is thinking about how much they hate their agent for landing them a job on these stupid crap streets.
Oh my God, I'm here in New York with all the famous people. And in Times Square, there are so many giant screens, as wide as the rivers in Mason. And so many people, and so many restaurants. All the people in Mason, Massachusetts are about 1/100 of the people here. I see a million people as I buy clothes and accessories from Gap and Claire's. I'm so happy that Daddy had a business trip here. Bessie is not going to believe this. Delicious food coming from Starbucks. I just have to buy something. The taste of coffee, perfect as it's supposed to be. Here are 1,000 people, also famous and smart and rich and stylish. I feel the softness of one of the clothes made by a Swedish designer, and I know that deep down everyone is thinking, wow, New York City, wow.
The cracks in the old apartment. I live in a forgotten place that is only checked once in a year. So, I have a year here, which is why it's one of my best finds. And all the time I have been here, I have been waiting for my ticket to fame, which will happen to soon, I hope. The only thing better than a ticket to fame is a ticket to eat anything for free at Katz's Deli for a day. I walk down, slip through the unknown crack at the edge of an alley next to the local pharmacy, take a piece of my favorite bagel chip, allow myself to be seen so when I'm famous I will have no secrets. I go around the city and eat as I can, running my fingers across the buildings, looking for openings, feeling the bricks and the cement, tasting the New York bagel turned into a chip, watching the movements of the people in case they drop something, in case I see them before and they catch me once in the act of stealing something. Smell dust and perfume mixed together, making a very interesting aroma. When I realize that it's almost dark, that it's time to slip into my apartment while no one's looking. As I rush past home, I hear the angry crowd yelling at me for pushing them aside. But they will all adore me when I am famous. And I realize that deep down, everyone is thinking that New York is a place where people go to find fame and fortune, but instead they find peace.
You have heard the voices of 4 different voices. One positive.
One negative.
One overexcited.
One hopeful.
These 4 different people, one an actor, one his agent, one his daughter who won a Katz Deli raffle, then lost it, and the man who has it now. All these different interpretations mean one thing.
Though we may be different on the outside, on the inside we're connected in a way we never knew. So,
if you go out and buy a book,
or talk to someone,
or lie down and listen to music,
it could make an impact on any number of people.
So you can do it. And you should. Just keep in mind that whatever you do, it will affect someone.
One way or another.
Thank you.
menu, Jennifer Richards, and she wrote The Battle of Day versus Night. This is Jane Hertz, she wrote The Misinterpretations of Stewie, and this is Serena Alagapin, and she wrote Finding the Moon. Let's give them a round of applause.
He wrote the whole